name is Tamara Blair, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe and watch some more videos while you're here. So for today's video, I'll basically be talking about the worst financial mistakes that I've made so far in my 20s. So for those of you who don't know, I'm 23. And honestly, I don't know how I feel about that age. Like, I feel like I'm still young, but then I feel like I'm super old at the same time. Like, I don't know. But anyway, I wrote down a few stuff here so that I don't forget. I don't want to ramble too much because I don't want to make this video super, super long. So let's just get straight into the video. Okay, so I have a little list here. And like I said, I'm 23, so I'm not super old, but I'm not super young at the same time. And some of these financial mistakes, I would say, started when I was about 18. I've always been super independent and just super independent and super mature from a very young age. So I started working. I got my first official job at the age of 16. My first job was McDonald's, and I thought I was big ballin', thought that I was bossing up. So basically, I would say I started making financial mistakes from that age. So let's just go down the list. Let's not get into it too much. So the first financial mistake that I would say I make a lot would be, hold on y'all, let me write stuff down before I forget. Okay, so the first financial mistake that I would say I made, well, I'm continuing to make, is to spend money on food. And I know you guys are thinking, what the heck, but yes. If you guys sit down and calculate how much money you spend on food, like, I bet you'd be saying, just like me, that you're wasting money. So the reason why I say I waste money on food is because I work a lot, so a lot of times I'm not home. So even if my boyfriend cooks, or I don't even know if I cook, sometimes, like, I just don't eat that food. Like, I'm at work more than I'm at home, so I usually eat at work. So especially now with, like, Corona and stuff like that, obviously I'm not going out to eat. But I do still order food a lot. So at work, I'll order food every single day. And I've tried so many times to break that habit. I've tried packing lunch. I'll bring fruits to work. I'll bring, like, little snacks. And then I eat it all. And for whatever reason, like, I'm still hungry. So I still end up ordering food. So what I did was, 1 week, I calculated how much money I spent on food. And I was basically ordering food at work every single day and spending $20 or more every day on food. So for 1 week, I was spending around $100, $120 on food alone. And that's just ordering food. That's not even how much, including how much I would spend on groceries. So that to me is a waste of money. I think with $120, I could have gotten a lot of groceries, meal prepped, and had food prepped for my lunch every week, and would have saved myself so much money. But yeah, that's like my first biggest financial mistake, I would say, that I'm still working on. Hopefully I will start meal prepping more often so I can stop wasting money. But yeah, so the next financial mistake that I would say, again, I'm still continuing to make, is my hair. Now, my black queens, you know, we get our hair done all the time, switching up hairstyles all the time. And for me, I'm one of those people, I get my hair done and I'll take it out in like a week or 2 weeks. I've been in situations before where I've done my hair, or I've tried to, like, try something new and I don't like it and I end up taking it out the same day. Now, that's a lot of money. And you ladies know, nowadays we're spending $100, $200, sometimes more to get our hair done. So to take it out the same day or to take it out a week later is just a big waste of money. There was a month that I calculated I spent over $600 on my hair, and around my birthday I spent like $1,000 on my hair. That's way too much money. That's unnecessary. So that's actually one of my biggest goals. Through quarantine, I've cut off all my hair. I will not be inserting a picture because I straight up look like a little boy. But when quarantine first started, I did a big chop, so I have no hair right now. Like, shout out to my hairstylist, because I don't know how she was able to grip my little hair to get these braids in, but I cut off all my hair when quarantine first started, so I'm hoping to grow back my hair to its natural, beautiful, healthy form. Like, no more perms, no more dyes, no more none of that. Like, I cut it off and now I'm going completely natural and just doing protective styling. So I'm trying to keep my braids in for a month, maybe 2 months if I make it. But yeah, I'm definitely trying to cut back on spending money, not spending money, because obviously I'm still going to spend money on my hair, but just spending excessively on my hair, I should say. The next thing on my list would be credit cards. So now we're getting seriously into the mistakes. So credit cards could be your best friend or your worst enemy. So me, like I said, I got my first job at 16. So as soon as I hit 18, I thought I was a big baller. So I got my first credit card exactly at the age of 18 because I was, honestly, I don't know why. I was just so ready to start adulthood. I honestly thought I was such an adult at 18. Like, y'all just don't even know. But I was just so ready to start building my credit. Just, I don't know, to start adulthood. So I literally got my first credit card at 18, literally on my birthday. I got a credit card. And my first credit card was a Capital One, like, you know, those student credit cards or whatever. So that was my first credit card. And when I first got it, I was doing very, very, very well with credit cards. I would only use it for small things. So I would use it for gas or like for food, like for snacks, and I would completely pay it off by the end of the month. Now, my advice to you guys, that's the best way to use a credit card. Whatever you spend for that month, pay it off by the end of the month. Don't let it roll over for the next month. Like, don't be like, oh, I'll just pay a minimum payment of $25 and pay the rest next month. Don't do it. Like, don't do it. You're just setting yourself up for failure, and it's just going to keep rolling over and rolling over, and the interest is just going to be piling up, and then next thing you know, you're just in credit card debt. So that was one of my biggest financial mistakes. I don't think it was a mistake to get the credit card so early. I just think it's how I used the credit card that put me in debt. So that's another thing. After getting that credit card, I didn't stop there. I got a Victoria's Secret credit card because I was going to Victoria's Secret a lot. I got a Wells Fargo credit card. Like, I was just getting credit cards back to back to back. And you don't need all these credit cards to build your credit. You can have amazing credit with one credit card. Don't let people tell you, oh, open a credit card for this, for that. Like, you go to all your favorite stores and you open credit cards. Like, this is affecting your credit. You do not need all these credit cards. It's just going to put you in debt. And that's exactly what happened to me. I opened all these credit cards, and then before you knew it, I am thousands and thousands of dollars in debt. Like, I basically paid most of them off. So what I've been doing, I've been paying off my credit cards and just cutting them up. Like, I don't want to see them. I don't want them anymore. Like, every time I pay off a credit card, I close the account and, like, to just be done with it. So Victoria's Secret, Capital One, like, all those credit cards, I paid them off and closed the account because I don't want to see them. And then, like, I don't want nothing to do with them. So now I just have one credit card, which is my Wells Fargo credit card, and that's it. Like, that's all I need. I don't need all these credit cards. So I basically paid them all off, cut them up, closed the accounts, and that was it for my credit cards. Until, so that brings me into my next financial mistake. Is this my fourth one? I think so. So this is my fourth financial mistake, was My Little Princess Roxy. So if you guys haven't watched that video yet, I will link it in the description down below of how I got my dog. So if you didn't know, I have a dog. Her name is Roxy. She's about a year and like 6 months ish. I could be wrong. I don't know, honestly. That's sad to say, but anyway, so I have a dog. Her name is Roxy. My boyfriend and I got her about a year and 6 months ago. And to get her, once again, we had to take out a credit card. So I got her from Petland, which, before I get into that, this was a huge mistake, you guys. Like, if you want a pet, go to the shelter, adopt a pet, you know, ask a friend, go on Facebook. A lot of time, people are giving away pets for free. Like, you know, their animals have too many puppies or whatever the case may be. Do not buy a dog. I mean, if you have the money, by all means, buy a dog, but don't buy a dog. Like, it's such a waste of money. There's so many dogs in shelters that need to be adopted. Like, just don't do it. But anyway, this was my huge financial mistake. So we bought a dog, and she was $4,000. Yes, you heard me right. I spent $4,000 on a dog. She's a mini Labradoodle mix, whatever. So to get her, we had to take out a credit card. So I got her from Petland. So we took out a Petland credit card and was basically paying that card every month. Now, like I said, that was another huge financial mistake for me. That was $4,000 down the drain. Don't get me wrong, I love my dog. I would not trade her for anything. Like, she makes me happy. She makes my family happy. I love her to pieces, but $4,000 for a dog was a huge financial mistake. That was so unnecessary. Like I said, there's so many other ways to get pets. You can adopt, you can ask a friend, go on Facebook. Like, people are always giving away pets for free. There's no reason I should have spent $4,000 on a dog. Like, now that I sit and think about it, like, that was absurd. That was just, I don't know what I was thinking. That was, anyway, like I said, I'm just sharing my mistakes with you guys so you don't make these same financial mistakes. Okay, so after Roxy, I would say my next financial mistake would be YouTube. And I know you guys are thinking, YouTube? Yes, YouTube. So when I first started off YouTube, like, I'm still to this day investing money into YouTube. So I know a lot of people think, like, they think, oh, you're on YouTube, like, you're making all this money, blah, blah, blah. Well, no. I'm not, I haven't passed my threshold yet. Like, YouTube has a lot of requirements before you start making money. I can make a whole separate video on that if you guys want me to. But basically the threshold is, like, for example, the first one is you have to have 1,000 subscribers, which I do. Thank you guys so much for that. So you have to have 1,000 subscribers and you have to have 4,000 watch hours. There's like other stuff too that you have to go through, but those are the two main things. You have to have more than 1,000 subscribers or more, and then you have to reach 4,000 watch hours, which I haven't reached my 4,000 watch hours yet. That's why I haven't started making money. So make sure you watch my videos, watch them all the way through. Tell your friends, tell your cousins, tell your aunties to come watch my videos. But basically, I haven't reached my threshold of 4,000 watch hours yet. That's why I haven't started making money. So for people out there that are trying to make a YouTube channel or you're considering it, this is the path that you want to take. Don't go out and buy all this equipment, buy all this stuff, like, to have this huge, beautiful setup for your YouTube channel. Trust me, it's completely unnecessary. Like, I don't have a YouTube setup, so I wouldn't say I spent a huge amount of money into YouTube, but I still did. So right now I still don't have a setup. I'm just sitting in my living room casually making this video. But I did spend a lot of money. So I bought a camera, which was like $600, $600 or $700. I don't remember, but I spent a good amount of money on my camera. I bought a ring light. I have three ring lights, actually. I don't know why. So I bought like three ring lights that I have, and then basically all these try-on hauls. So all these videos that I do on YouTube, all these try-on hauls, so like my bikini try-on hauls, like my clothing try-on hauls, Savage X Fenty try-on hauls, none of those videos are sponsored. Like, I buy all those items myself out of my own pocket. So that's me investing a lot of money into YouTube that I'm not generating back as yet. So if you're a YouTuber and you're making money, I think it's fine to invest, because obviously you need to invest in something to make money in the end. But don't go right off the bat, spend like $2,000, $3,000 in these, like, to have like a huge YouTube setup. And for what? Like, if you're trying to start off, I would say start making videos on your phone, because for one, you might not even know if YouTube is for you. I still don't know if YouTube is for me. I'm just trying it out. But start off on your phone. Just make small videos on your phone. You do not need this huge setup. Like, you don't need a ring light. You don't need a huge fancy camera to do YouTube. Like, you just don't need it. And I wish someone had told me that before I invested so much money into it. Because, like I said, it still might not be for me. I'm still trying it out. But yeah, all these try-on hauls, like, all this stuff, like, I pay that on my own. So that's money that I'm investing into YouTube that I haven't even generated back yet. So that's still a huge financial mistake for me. So you guys might see a little switch up of my content. I might stop doing try-on hauls. Like, I might not, like, let me not say stop. I don't think I'll stop doing try-on hauls, but I'll probably be doing them less and start doing other types of content. I'm planning on starting working out soon, so I'll probably be doing workout videos and other stuff like that instead of trying, like, so many try-on hauls, because, like I said, I'm investing my money into YouTube that I haven't started generating back yet. So, but yeah, so that was another, what was that, number five? I don't even know, like, I'm not even keeping track. I have a whole list, but I don't want to make this video super long, like I said, so I'm going to stop at this last one, which is cars. So cars, and this is, I would say, the biggest financial mistake I've made so far in my entire life. So I bought my first car in 2015. That was the year I graduated high school. So I graduated high school, and on my birthday that year, I bought a car. So that was my first car. Like, I was so obsessed with it, and I don't know what happened. Like, I think 6 months later or a couple months later, I switched my car. I could make a whole nother video about cars, because this is like, if I get into it, like, this video is gonna be like an hour long. Like, that's like a whole nother story. But basically, to sum it all up, I've changed my car every single year, if not more than that. I think so, more than that. But I've changed my car every single year, starting from 2015 now to 2020. So over the past 5 years, I've changed my car every single year, maybe more, because I think there was a time that I changed it like after 6 months. So I've changed my car a lot. Like, I've had like 5 or 6 cars in the span of 5 years, which is very bad. That's so unnecessary. Don't ever do that. But every single time that I was changing my car, I would put down a down payment. So my first car, I saved up all through high school. Not all through high school. Like, I would say like my senior year is when I started taking saving like seriously. So I spent like my senior year saving up money and all that stuff. And I went to go buy my first car. So that was like, I put down like $5,000. My second car, I put down like $2,000. Like, every single time I was changing my car, I was putting money down. So that's like $10,000 to $15,000 that I could have had in my pocket right now. And then the last time I changed my car, instead of trading it in, no one would let me trade it in, so I sent it back to the bank and they auctioned it off or whatever, and the mileage was super high on that car, so they weren't able to auction it off for a lot, I guess. So basically, the balance that was left on the car, I have to pay it. So now I'm paying 2 car payments every single month, and I will be paying 2 car payments every month for 3 years. So if you guys want a story time on that, let me know, and I will definitely do a video on that, because that was just a whole crazy story. And like I said, that's my biggest financial mistake, because I'm obviously still living through that right now. Like, I will be paying 2 car payments for the next 3 years. But anyway, that was the last thing on my list. If you guys want a part 2 to this video, let me know, because I have a lot of financial mistakes that I've made and some that I'm still making. So if you guys want to know about those, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Leave a comment if you want a part 2, and I can definitely do a part 2 for you guys. I hope you guys are staying safe and staying healthy through this crazy pandemic. But yeah. Don't forget to follow me on all my social medias at Tamara Blair, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Peace!